Welcome to fifth grade photography. This is lesson two, and it's all about something called leading lines. Follow along with me as I read this to you. The concept of leading lines is simple, but often ignored. A leading line draws the viewer's eye to the subject and or around the photo. A leading line can be almost anything. A road, path, sidewalk, fence, river, hedge, that's like bushes, tree, shadow, etc. You will not find a strong leading line around every subject, but you should look for them as you are taking your picture. Often, if you shoot from a different angle, you'll find a leading line. And by that one, I mean, if you lay down on the ground to get a good shot, or you point your camera up at a different angle, instead of just holding it at standing level, like you're used to holding it, try laying down, or try shooting it up if you see something, or bending over to take a picture. I'm going to show you some examples of what a leading line is. Let's go to the next page. This path is an example of a leading line. Without even realizing it, your eyes follow along that path until they end up right here where this yellow circle is. So these yellow lines have been added to show you where your eye travels in this photograph. You actually, your eyes walk right along that path and they end up right here. No matter what you do as you look for this picture, you will find if you look away, and you look back, your eyes always end up right here because the path line, the where the path is traveling, leads your eyes to this point. Let's try another one. Let's look at this picture right here. This photographer has used leading lines in the picture. When you look at this picture, take a look at it for a minute and see where your eyes end up. If you're like most people, your eyes will follow this line right down here, and they will end up looking at this part of the picture. So if you look away and you look back at the picture again, your eyes are going to settle in this spot right here because the photographer used this leading line to bring your eyes to that point. Let's drag this one over here and see where you end up. Here's another use of leading lines. This photographer taking a picture of a bridge included the railings of the bridge. So when you look at this picture, think, where do your eyes end up looking? If you follow the lines, they should end up looking right here where my mouse is circling. These leading lines, all of these lines are leading your eyes to end up right here. Let's try some more. How about this? This photographer used the highway to line up with the rising moon. So when you look at this picture, your eyes end up right at the moon. One, because it's really bright in a dark picture. But these highway lines lead you right to the main part of this picture. Let's try another one. These lines in the sand should lead your eyes to a certain spot. If you look at this picture, most people's eyes will end up right here where my mouse is circling because these lines are all leading to that one spot in the picture. Okay, are you getting it now? Let's try some more. This is a place called Monument Valley. This person got out in the middle of the highway and took a picture using the highway as a leading line. And that highway leads your eye. When you look at this picture, it follows it right down, and your eyes end up looking right here where the highway ends. Look again. Your eyes always end up there because of the leading lines. Let's drag another picture out here. All right, I'll give you a second and think, where are your eyes ending up looking? If you're like most people, they run right down the dock here and your eyes end up right here at the end of the dock. That's where you end up looking at in this picture. Let's try another one. Here's a picture of a highway. Most people, when they look at this picture, their eyes will actually follow along the line of that highway, and they will end up someplace here in this dark section of the photograph. Your eyes will actually follow those leading lines of the highway. Okay, ready to try some more? Let's look at this one. If you're like most people, your eyes end up right here in the picture. Let's drag another one down. Are you getting it? Here's another one. Look at it for a minute, and where your eyes end up looking should be right here, because this is the spot where all the lines are leading to. Let's pull another picture out. Picture of this curvy path, and as you look at this picture, you're going to follow with your eyes all the way and end up here, because that's where the path stops. Let's try another one. Here's a picture of some railroad tracks. Your eyes will follow right down the tracks, and it will end up looking right here in this photograph. Think you're getting it by now. Here's a couple of my photographs that I dug out to show you leading lines. When you look at this picture, your eyes should climb right up that tree trunk and end up at the top of this picture, because this tree trunk is a strong leading line to the top of the photograph. Okay, here's another picture I took. I used the highway. So the highway leads you right up. Now my eyes actually stop right in this area because the highway stops. So when I look at this picture, my eyes stop right here, and I have to make my eyes look up to see the mountains up here. Okay, that's the use of leading lines. Few more to show you. I think you're getting it here. This picture shows a different angle. Now, I had to actually lay down on the road here to take this picture. The road was closed, so there was no danger there, but I laid down on the road to use the yellow line to lead you right to the mountains into the distance. And this, I lined up these doorways. This was in New Mexico in an ancient Native American site that they lined their doors up. And to take the picture, I wanted your eyes to follow all the way through the doors. And when you look at this picture, your eyes should end up right here. So if you look away and look back, you're going to see this is where your eyes rest, right at this spot here. And finally, our last picture for leading lines. This is up on a path behind St. Mary's University. And in the fall, you can see that your eyes will walk right up that path, and they will go right up to here, and they will end up looking right here in this photograph. Your assignment is going to be to look for leading lines to use in your next pictures. You have to look for them. They don't always just jump out. You have to maybe lay down or find something that will use leading lines to let your eyes go to a certain point in a picture.